everyone. I hope you're, oh, the locks are definitely popping. But yeah, I hope you're all being kind to yourself and others. I know it's a lot changing in the world, and it can be a lot for some people and scary at times. But just remember that all change isn't bad change. Keep that in mind when things do evolve in this realm. Today, I'm going to be talking about why we call these beautiful, luscious strands of fiber locks instead of dreadlocks or dreads. I'm also going to get into gratitude and why that's so important for our soul. Lastly, I'm going to talk about why evolving is one of the best things we can do for us and the planet. Just remember that I always speak from my heart, and my mission is to spread love and light with necessary chaos every single time. I hope you guys enjoyed the video, and make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. This is not going to be a long video at all, so please try to watch it all the way to the end. Like, my baby's on my car right now. We're going to get right into it. I'm not playing. All right. Firstly, dreadlocks didn't become a thing until the late 1950s. It was like 1959 or something like that. We never used to call it that. And it's funny because life and a lot of things that happen in life go in a continuous circle. Colonizers actually made the dread part of it a thing. And I think they were, I'm not a teacher, like I'm meant to enlighten, but I am very knowledgeable, and this is something that I study. But if you want the full in-depth story and all, you need to go do your own research. Like, it's so much information out there, and libraries out there, that, and people out there that actually went through this and experienced this, that it would be crazy to not go get that information rather than just speaking on your opinion. So these are facts. We never used to call it dreadlocks. This is something that white people, colonizers, the British, put upon our hair because they thought it was dreadful. If you look up the word dread, it means greatly feared. Dreadful means greatly feared. Why would they do this, you say? I'm about to tell you. It's because we should be feared. We're so powerful, and we used to really notice and understand this about ourselves. I'm talking about us, people that look like me. So we're not gonna pretend like we didn't go through what we went through with slavery and things like that and act like that's not a thing. Before we had this self-hatred and started perming our hair and things like that, hair was so important to us and so powerful. It's getting back like that now. A lot of people are woke. A lot of people been knew that, and it's slowly becoming more public in society. And I love the change. I think it's great. Back to the dreadful word. I think that this is important for people to know and understand, because a lot of people don't, and a lot of people are ignorant towards it. That's literally what it means when you don't know something. Like, I'm ignorant towards boats. I would never like speak on that and be like, oh yeah, let's go sailing and we can do this and that's how you hang the, because I don't know nothing about it. When I'm speaking on something, this is something that I've, like, you know, researched. It's really simple. It's really that simple. The word dreadlocks comes from the word dreadful. If you look it up, that's what it says. This is something you can find on dictionary.com. You know what I'm saying? And I get that people still call it dreads, or they're okay with that and they don't know where it comes from, or maybe they do know where it comes from and still don't care. But regardless, I'm enlightening you in case you don't know. And I think it's important for everybody to know that, because words are so powerful. There's nothing dreadful, there's nothing fearful about our hair, and I think that that's so important to realize, because for so long we were taught that, oh, you should perm your hair to make that easier, oh, you should do this, and oh, you should wear wigs, and natural hair isn't done, and you know what I mean? And I just think that's not right. So that's my mission for this video. Uno momento. Okay, had to start rocking him. But yeah, I just definitely wanted to speak on it, because I know so many people don't know that that's what it means. But like, my thing is, once you figure that out, I feel like it's okay to change that, or just call it hair. At the end of the day, you can do whatever you want. A lot of people will be like, oh, well, it's not that deep and da da da, but words are powerful, like we were just talking about. So when you keep saying things aren't that deep, they'll continue not to be that deep. My hair is very deep to me. And when it comes to the gratitude, I just definitely want to give thanks and give gratitude to my parents and my stepmom, because she actually enabled me wearing my natural hair. I used to straighten my hair a lot, and she put the aloe vera plant in my hair and just did it natural and said that you should wear your hair natural, it's really pretty. And I was just kind of like, I was in high school, I'm like, whatever, I just wore it straight. And she awakened that crown chakra for me pertaining to my hair, you know what I mean? I'm just very grateful to her for that. I'll set you guys down. She doesn't even know this, but she's gonna watch the video and she'll know. But I'm very grateful, and that did a lot for me. I just wish that we were more knowledgeable on the perms and things like that, because at the end of the day, if you don't know something, you don't know something. This isn't an attack, this isn't anything like that. People just simply didn't know. That's due to it being forced upon our people with the perms and the wigs and the straightening your hair. I just think it's blatantly insane to like know this knowledge, or maybe not know and not want to know. You get what I'm saying? And I feel like if you do have locks and you enable people that do call it that, or you don't even know where that word originated from, you should go ahead and cut your shit off, because it's giving house slave. It's giving like, oh master, I'll do this for you for a piece of bread. Like, I don't like that. I'm very passionate about it because it is that deep to me. It was a time where I wasn't as confident and I didn't like my natural hair. I'm gonna just be honest, I didn't like it. It was so difficult to do. Like, you know those memes on TikTok and things like that when people would be crying and stuff like that doing their hair? That is very real, especially for the black woman. Like, our hair is definitely just more thick. It's a lot more to handle. Back to the gratitude, I mentioned my parents, and I think that the way that they loved me, the way that they cared for me and always like enabled anything I wanted to do, regardless if I had stage fright, regardless of anything like that, they always believed in me and they always did their best. And oh, my baby, he's having a dream. Get away from my baby. Okay. But yeah, I just definitely want to give them much, much gratitude, including my stepmom, because they always supported everything I did. And I think when we don't love our hair, or we don't love ourselves, that stems from your root chakra. And that's a whole nother topic, but root chakra is like trust. It's where you come from. It usually stems from childhood. And you know, this is the Kamari show. When you come on here, you're gonna hear me. So I'm just speaking, you know, right now about, you know, how I feel personally, because I love my locks, and I've had a very intense but humble journey with them, because we all know in the beginning it can get kind of like, like, what is that? But then it's almost to the middle of my back now. Almost. You know what? It is to the middle of my back. A hater would be like, it's not to the middle of your back yet. But words are powerful, so watch it be to the middle of my back next week. Last but definitely not least, I would like to thank my grandpa, because he was very, very knowledgeable and smart. I think he enabled that for a lot of my family. Like, I have a lot of just very grateful for him, and even knowing the stories about him when I was younger. Unfortunately, he's in the astrals right now, but his spirit lives on. His legacy lives on. He's definitely a legend. And I feel like just him enabling himself enabled the generations after him, his kin, all that. Shout out to my grandpa. Last topic I'm gonna talk about is evolving. It's like you go one or two ways with it. For some, it can be scary and it's like they wanna stay the same, but I'm here to let y'all know that that's called homeostasis. And I made a video about this like 4 years ago when I was 20. I might just insert the clip where I'm talking about it. Yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and insert the clips to make it easier. So here we go. Homeostasis is the true resistance from change. So that means that you like to be familiar with things. You like for things to be similar. The thought of something bigger or something too different scares you. So you tend to stay in the same places a lot. And that can cause you to go in circles and not reach your full potential in life. I feel like a lot of people do that, especially because of people's discouraging comments, lack of support, and people being negative. I just want to let you know, I believe in you. You can do it. You got it. You're almost there. And if you're almost there, don't ever give up in anything. You shouldn't have started in the first place if you're going to give up. So that's homeostasis, and that's a condition. When you're afraid of change in a changing world, I think that those people are just gonna get left behind in the same spot, or you gonna get on with the wave. When we were in a certain stage back in the day, I definitely think they did everything they could, but my generation is like the first generation that young to be billionaires. They're the first generation making tons of money on the internet. Like, it's so much that is going on now. If we were all to come together as a whole, we can make society even greater than it is. Like, I'm not gonna get too much into this topic, but y'all hear about the government shutting down and things like that. I don't know too much about that, but I do know that it's a great change coming. So you can either get with the program or you can get left behind. It's nothing to be feared. I think that it's a lot of great things happening. Although, you know, there's distractions with a lot of chaos, it's necessary chaos. And that's what I am sometimes. If you want me to do like a more in-depth video on the topic, I definitely can, but that's pretty much the gist, like literally. People like me that are on the spiritual path that I'm on, they're just taking their power back. That's all it stems down to. So I feel like when you put that word in front of it, it brings us back to those days when the house slaves and like what I was talking about. So I'm just here to enlighten and just let y'all know that that's why, in case anybody didn't know. You can always come back to this video and know. If you're different or you don't think like everybody else, you're meant to do something really, really important. So in case nobody told you that, I just wanted to tell you that. And I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Oh, like I was saying, if you want me to get more in depth on the topic, I definitely can, but I'm not a teacher. Like, the teacher's mission is to make sure that you get it. And quite frankly, I don't care if you get it or not. I will enlighten, because that's what I'm meant to do, but I'm not about to sit there and keep going over it and over it just to make sure you get it. Because at the end of the day, maybe you're not meant to get it. That's what it is. They're locks. There's nothing dreadful about it. I do need y'all to understand that the word dreads, though, is disrespectful. So that's all it is. Thank you guys for watching. You got the right one. Hey. Two steps. Can I rock with you? Can I smoke with you? Hiya. Hey. Trying to give you an upgrade. Cherry bottoms to your shades. Take my debit and go crazy.